Hi folks, I'm Adam, and I've been working on a team minigame for the past few days in which the game ends when either team scores 5 points. However, it only occurred to me today that I'd actually need to display each team's score. Now, Minecraft has scoreboards, Minecraft has teams, but it doesn't have team scores just yet. It will only display each user's score. Now, I could just give every player on the team a point every time a point is scored by that team, but then you'll just end up with, say, 5 blues all with 3 points and then 5 reds all with 2 points. All displayed in a rather silly looking list. So I decided to try and combine the scoreboards and the team functionality so that only the team names would display in the sidebar. Turns out it's much easier said than done, but hopefully this guide will help you to understand what I did if you want to use it for your own game. I mean, it probably won't, but my intentions are good. Now, here's our two example teams. Team Hambuster are red, and Team Clingetungler are blue. First off, we'll set our goal. To make a new goal, type in scoreboard objectives add, and then come up with a code name. I used points, PTS, and then I set the score to dummy, which effectively means redstone controlled. Finally, you set the name that will display on the sidebar. I went for awesome points. Now, you're not done with this step. You actually have to create a second objective, points 2 in this case. Both points and points 2 will have the same scores, but the original one is just for display purposes. This is the one that will detect a winning team. Now, this command will set the awesome points to display on the sidebar. I'll also bind the actual points to tab so that you can get a better idea of what's happening, but you just keep them hidden in the actual game. Now it's time to create the teams. As we said before, the red team is Hambuster and the blue team is Clingetungler. As well as these real teams, we also have to create some fake teams to display in the sidebar. As only players display there, we'll have to fake some players. Using our points goal, we'll make a fake player Hambuster and give him a point to put him on the table, and then we'll do the same with a fake player Clingetungler. Now we can assign these fake teams to their real teams so that they can gain their team colour. I'll also add me and my mate to these real teams, him on red and me on blue. To give the teams their correct colour, we can just run these commands and you'll notice that the fake teams in the sidebar and us two players have had our names coloured to that of our team. Now, we'll reset the awesome points scores of Hambuster and Clingetungler to 0. This requires specific commands, as a global command like the one in this command block will only affect players in the world, not these non-existent players disguised as teams. So, that's the setup all done. Yeah, I didn't understand a word of what I just said either. Oh well, you can just copy the commands and you should be golden. Now, we can start adding points to our teams. Each time we add a point, this front command block adds a point to the score in the sidebar. This does nothing, as there's no way to detect when these non-existent players hit 5 points, it's purely for show. However, this back command block is adding points to every actual member on that team, as you can see on the server menu. So, when the players in either team hit 5 points, these test 4 command blocks will pick up on it and announce the winning team. Supposedly. Let's give it a go. And there we have it, team scores displayed via the scoreboard. Hopefully you'll see the project I've been figuring this out for very soon, but until then, thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.